She's a happy kid. She's awesome. Aside from, you know, her hands being different, she's just like any typical awesome loving kid.
Sidney came to us about 2.5 years ago with mom and her occupational therapist. And the first thing I noticed was she had limitations with both of her arms. She was missing part of her hand on the right, and her left hand was virtually not usable.
One of my arms isn't like an actual hand. It's just like there. It's just really stiff.
She can do a lot of things. She can do some really amazing, cool things. But there were simple everyday tasks that she could not accomplish.
Being able to pump a spray bottle to put perfume on, or, you know, to be able to brush her hair, or she likes to wear little lip gloss and stuff like that. She definitely struggles with those things that we all take for granted today.
I knew that we could do something. I wasn't sure exactly at that point, but the more we talked, the more we decided that the island hand was the way to go for her. The company that produces this hand, they're called Touch Bionics. We took Sidney and Mom up to Ohio for the fitting. They helped train me on how to operate the hand and how to teach her how to operate it. There's a small electrode with two metal contacts, and those lay in line with the muscle in her arm. And when she fires the muscle, it picks up the little microelectric signal off of that muscle belly. And that signal is basically an on-off switch that tells the hand to open or close. She can also use it to change the type of grip if she wants to go from grabbing a glass to picking up a pencil.
For most of us, the action of opening and closing our hand is automatic. We don't have to think to reach or to grab something or to bring something to our mouth to eat. For children like Sidney, it's a process. It's relearning how to use the new prostheses to make it do the things that she needs it to. It's not simply, I want to reach out and grab something. It's, I have to activate the muscles to make my hand open and close. That requires a tenacity that children like Sidney often have to show throughout their life.
I practice using my muscle, opening and closing the hand. I'm going to have 30-minute sessions 2 times a day.
Best case scenario, I'm hoping that she will come back and she will still have that level of excitement, and she'll tell me that she's wearing that arm every day and that she's beginning to do things with it, do things that are useful in her life.
It feels great. Like, lots of people donated all this money just to help me get this, and I'm just really thankful for it.